Hello everyone and welcome to our third set of videos in the NCB's Home Science Resources. And today we are going to be going on a treasure hunt in your own kitchen, which I suppose you've probably not done one of those before. I mean, I certainly have not been on a treasure hunt in my own house. So today we're going to be chatting about different foods and specifically the dates found on those foods. So why are they on there? What do they mean? And can I really eat something that's out of date? Watch the video to find out more. So in the whole world, approximately one third of all food that is produced is lost or wasted. That is a colossal amount. So if we now think about the UK, 70% of food wasted in the UK happens in our own homes. So homes just like mine and yours. And that amount is 4.5 million tons if we take out inedible food, such as banana skin and eggshells. Now, I want you to think about an elephant, a really big male elephant, and the amount of food we waste at home in the UK, so that's everyone in the whole UK population, is equivalent to the weight of 750,000 African bush male elephants. Now, that is a lot of elephants. And more to the point, that's a huge amount of food. It's not just bad for the environment, but it costs the average family like yours and mine £730 per year. So today we're going to be talking about food waste and give you a little bit more education about food waste and dates on food. So before we go any further in the video, we need to define what food waste actually is. Now, there's no legal definition of food waste, but what I'm talking about is any food, including inedible parts of food, that are removed from the food supply chain to the chain that it goes on from the farm to your fork at home when you're eating your food on your plate, and any food that's been recovered, such as sent to charities because there's been a surplus of food in the supermarkets, or thrown away in the bin. So inedible food waste refers to things like chicken bones. It can refer to eggshells, just like this. It could also refer to tomato vines, which you can't eat, like this. Or banana skins, so things on the food that you can't actually eat and you have to put them in the bin or the compost. But as we mentioned just now, there's still lots of edible food that's going to waste. So that could be the small amount of food that's left on your plate each night, because actually that adds up across the week. Vegetable peelings that could actually have just been eaten on your carrot or thrown into some soup or made some stock. And the humble bread crust. So many bread crusts get thrown away in the UK, when actually it's just a perfectly good slice of bread. And one thing that's really important to help prevent all this food going to waste is understanding the dates on your food. So on food packaging, the beady-eyed amongst you might have spotted a date in very small writing on the packaging. Sometimes it's on the back, sometimes it's on the front, or sometimes it's even on the bottom, or sometimes there's not even one at all. And there are two different types of date on food. We've got the use by date, and we have the best before, or abbreviated to the BB date on food. And together, we're going to be working out what the difference is between those two. But before we can do that, we need to go on a hunt around your kitchen. I want you to put your detective hat on and put your magnifying glass up. And I want you to find me two items with a use by date, two items with a best before date, and for a bonus mark, see if you can do this one, one item that doesn't have a date on it at all. That one's a little bit tricky, so see how well you can find these products within your kitchen. Now, if you get stuck, I'm going to have on the next slide some little hints that explain to you where you might be able to go and look if you're struggling to find one of the products. So go away now, pause the video, and if you get stuck, come back to the screen and it should be able to help you. I hope you were successful on your quest for treasure. I wonder how you got on. Did you manage to find everything? So let us know in the comments or via social media how you got on your treasure hunt in your house. So let's have a look at what I found. So with my use by dates, I found this pot of hummus in the fridge. So you can see it's got the little use by sign up there. And my final use by date was this pack of beef mince, which also had a use by date on it as well. And in terms of my best before dates, I found some mozzarella cheese, which was stored in the fridge. and that's got a best before date just down there. And I also found this really yummy cookie, and that had a best before date printed on it. And I also managed to find the bonus mark myself, and I wonder how many of you did. I managed to find something that didn't have a date on it, and that was this bottle of table salt. So I want you to think about what you found. There was a reason why I asked you to get two of each product. I want you to think about what the differences are. So what's the difference between my cookie and my cheese compared to my hummus and my beef mince? What's the difference between products that have a use-by date and products that have a best before date? So I hope you had a good discussion. Now, I don't know what you said, but perhaps it was something along the lines of use-by products need to be kept in the fridge and best before products need to be kept on the shelf or in the cupboard. Did you write something like that? That's quite a common thing that people think, and I guess it does suggest that the two products I had with use-by dates were in the fridge. However, that's not quite right, because my cheese is kept in the fridge and that has a best before date. And my yogurt that's also in the fridge has a best before date, not a use-by date. And there's some products like tomato ketchup, which we keep in the fridge after they've been opened. But generally, they have a best before date and we keep them on the shelf until they are opened. So that's not quite right. It's not that all products that have a use-by date need to go in the fridge. So we're going to move on now to the actual difference between the use-by dates and the best before. So use-by dates, reminder, just like my hummus here, the use-by date is to do with food safety. You need to use the product by a certain date. For example, with your meat or your fish, your milk, they go off really quickly. They need to be kept chilled in the fridge and they need to be eaten before the date. And if you can't use the food by that date, then you should freeze it if you can. The date has been set by microbiologists, so the bacteria in the food may have grown to a level that's too high for our immune systems and our health to deal with. And now we move on to the best before date. The best before date is all about food quality. The product is best before a certain date. And you can still eat your product after the date. So if I was to eat my cookie after its best before date, it would still be fine. It might just be not as chewy, or the biscuit might have gone a bit stale, or it might have lost some of its flavour. But you're not going to be ill, and it's definitely safe to eat. But one thing to really remember when we talk about this is, in order to trust the dates that are on the food, you need to store them correctly. So if it says remember to seal your cheese after you've eaten it and keep it in the fridge and use it after 5 days, you need to adhere to that to make sure that your dates are accurate. So I haven't forgotten about the food that didn't have a date on it, the bonus point. You might have found that if you found a big bottle of table salt or some vinegar or some granulated sugar. You may have found it on some vegetables or some fruit, some alcoholic beverages, if you managed to be as lucky to find one of those, some chewing gum, or maybe even on a fresh bakery item, such as a pan of chocolat that you'd bought from the shop and you were going to eat on the day. So, as you can see, not all foods need a best before or a use by date, and that's because the foods like I've just shown you have certain characteristics which mean they have a really long shelf life. Bacteria find it difficult to grow in environments where there is lots of acid, for example in the vinegar, lots of sugar, for example in our bag of sugar which is just pure sugar, or lots of salt, or even in lots of alcohol. And some supermarkets have decided to actually remove the dates on some of their fruits and vegetables so that you and I, the consumers of those vegetables, can decide if it's okay, rather than being led by the date. So now we know the difference between our dates, which ones are okay to eat after the date and which ones are not, and we should freeze them, we can help to reduce food waste in our house. Maybe you can think of some really inventive ways to use up things that you'd normally throw away. What about making breadcrumbs from your stale bread, or some breaded chicken, or some breaded fish, or making soup with all your leftover vegetables that are sat in the back of the fridge. Perhaps you could store up your leftovers from your dinner and have them for lunch the next day, and we'd love to see some of your ideas or even questions that you've got about food that you have left in the house, either in the comments or Instagram or Twitter. Let us know if you are using up your food in really inventive ways, because it's really important. And now that we're all at home and perhaps we can't go to the shops as much as we'd like to, there's all the more reason to be using up our food in the cupboard. Thanks for watching, everyone, and next week we are going to be looking at sensory science again, and we're going to be looking at different types of chocolate or biscuits depending on what you can buy, and we're going to be analysing them and doing some attribute profiling, which should be really fun. Bye, everyone.